life is all I have. My rhymes, my pen, my pad. And I done made it out the struggle, don't judge me. What you're saying now won't budge me. Cause where I come from, so often people you grow with laying in a coffin. But I done made it through the pain and strife. Is my tongue now my world, my life, my life.
CEO Stan Kasten is here, President of Baseball Ops Andrew Friedman, Executive VP General Manager Brandon Gomes is here, Manager Dave Roberts is here, and the rest of the Los Angeles Dodgers are here. And it's time to present the Commissioner's Trophy. Commissioner, all you.
On behalf of all of us in Major League Baseball, I want to congratulate the World Series champion, Los Angeles Dodgers. It's now my pleasure and honor to present this trophy to the President of Dodgers, Stan Kasten.
Well, we were just talking, Stan, that was a wild ride. What was it like watching this whole postseason and especially this series?
I mean, it was tense every night, every game, until the very last out. But I tell you what, I know why they call it the World Series, because this is the best feeling in the world.
Raise that up and enjoy it, Stan. Congratulations. Let's bring on Andrew Friedman here. And Andrew, you know, the depth of this team was really tested this whole postseason, right? All the injuries, you dealt with two during the regular season. The most gratifying thing for you about this whole organization and this team is what?
I gotta tell you, the number of fingerprints all over this win, from our scouting departments, player development, analysts, there's just a number of people who contributed to add to this group, this special group of players that not only competed the way they did, but they prepared. And what Blake Treinen and Walker Buehler did to finish this game out is incredible.
Andrew, congratulations.
Thank you.
Talk to Dave Roberts, huh? In 2020, you didn't get your parade because of the COVID situation. Well, you said you wanted a parade. You're going to get your parade. How does that sound?
Yeah! Who wants a parade?
Lucky, I'm just so, first and foremost, I thank God. I thank my players, their families, the coaching staff, training staff, ownership, scouting, player development, as Andrew said, the fingerprints on Dodger Nation. This trophy belongs to everybody.
Dave, this team's so resilient. Obviously, the incredible win in game one. You're down 5-0 in this game. How unbelievable was it to watch your guys keep fighting back?
It's unbelievable. You know, we had a great season, went through a lot of adversity. A lot of people counted us out, but every single one of these guys, and a lot of people that aren't here with us on this stage, made an impact. And these guys believed in one another. Even when we were down 5-0, they persevered, kept fighting, and now we're world champions.
Yeah, you are. Dave, one last one about this game specifically. Big moment, there were so many. But you go out to the mound in the eighth, and you talk to Blake Treinen, and you leave him in the game. Tell us about that conversation and why you left him in.
Yeah, you know what? I just wanted to look in Blake's eyes. Blake's our guy. Blake's been our guy. I just wanted to slow the game down a little bit. I looked in his eyes. I said, how you feeling? How much more you got? He said, I want it. I trust him.
World champs, how does that sound, Dave?
Oh, my!
Champion! right. We've got one more thing to do. Come on over here, Freddie. This is the Willie Mays Most Valuable Player Award presented by Chevrolet. Freddie Freeman, it's all yours. After everything that you've gone through this year, how special is this, this whole thing, winning it all, the MVP to you?
This is everything. I'm telling you, I wouldn't be here without the support of everybody in these shirts tonight. It's been a grind these last 3 months, but this organization, Stan, Andrew, Brandon, Doc, my teammates, my family, it's been a lot, and this is it right here. Not this, that one. Yeah, there you go. How does she feel?
Oh, she feels good. Every spring training, this is our goal. And for it to come true with this group of guys, I couldn't ask for a better year. Holy cow.
Freddie, you were on a heater, man. You tied a World Series record with 12 RBIs in this series. Every time you stepped to the plate, we felt like you were going to do something big, and you did. What was it like to be in that zone?
Yeah, 12 RBIs, that means there's a lot of my teammates on base. Heck of a job by everyone in this series. I'm glad I was able to get hot at the right time.
All right, tonight, tell us how you did it. You're down 5-0 after Mookie Betts beats that single out in the infield, right? You come up. Tell me what you're thinking there.
Yeah, so I think we were all saying it the first three innings, let's just get one. Just chip away. We can do this. There's a couple mistakes that happen, and you got to capitalize. They gave us some extra outs, and we were able to do that. Mookie putting in play, hustling down the line, getting the hit, tail, big two-run double, tied the game. I think we got to get Doc his flowers. Inning in the third, and he covered that game with our bullpen. Our bullpen did an incredible job. This is awesome. This is awesome.
Freddie Freeman, MVP, World Series champion, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, your world champion, Los Angeles Dodgers, everyone. Let's hear
the Dodgers win it in 5 games. You got plenty more coverage coming.
Say Freddie.
Here comes Freddie Freeman, the MVP.
I know, I gave you a hug, it's all good. How are you?
Freddie Freeman sitting down to join us. Well, I just had the pleasure of talking to Freddie. So why don't you guys have a chance to talk to our MVP here? Family is back.
Oh, man. Well, first of all, what's unbelievable is we had no idea of your status. You had a bum ankle. Yeah. Sometimes you played, then you would take a day off. We were up here wondering what was happening, and all of a sudden, in the World Series, you turned into Big Poppy. How'd you do it?
Those days off in between, like I said, were huge. I felt like in the NLDS and the NLCS, there's a fence, and I was always on the other side of it, trying to get the pain and my ankle swelling on that all down. I could never just get in front of it. And those few days helped me get on this side of the fence and got me in a great spot where I could work on my swing in those few days. And I found a cue, and it worked.
Freddie, congratulations.
Thank you.
Man, I mean, you have been amazing for the ball club. And you know how much I really love watching you play. But I want you to explain to people at home, because I've been trying to, but I never get quite there. I want you to try to explain to people what it's been on the zone, because every time you step on the plate, bro, it was like something happened before it happened.
Yeah. I wish I could explain the zone. I really do. But you just get into one of those zones where everything seems to slow down just enough. You're swinging at the right pitches. You're taking the balls.
For your World Series champions inside the clubhouse, we got mics that are hot. Hopefully, we get a chance to hear Dave Roberts speaking to his team here.
They're listening to, they not like us. They not like us. That's what they're listening to.
That was really the theme of the last month or so of this season. And those pitchers going shirtless again like they did in the previous three. champagne celebrations. Let's hear from Freddie Freeman inside the clubhouse with David Vesse.
How does this one feel? You're a two-time champ.
I know. This is everything you can ask for. The minute we stepped into spring training, we knew what kind of team we had. And this is a grind. The grind all season long. We faced every adversity possible. And we overcame every single one. And to be here as champions, this is everything.
Freddie, you guys committed yourselves when October began. How much did that help you guys get here?
No, you're not coming home right now. The party is underway inside the clubhouse. Yeah, give that commissioner's trophy even a shower of champagne as well. Oral, you've been there before, 1988. And you know what this moment feels like for all these guys.
It is crazy. You're so happy. You got goosebumps. You got cold champagne being poured over you. You got everybody and their mother congratulating you. You got media trying to pull at you and get interviews. But you just do everything you can to spend these moments with your teammates, with your coaches, with everybody that's helped you, the trainers, the travel staff. Everybody is getting wet and celebrating.
And there's that man, Shohei Ohtani. Some of these guys, that first time in that Dodger organization, and they go, this is what it's about. Man, they got to experience. And I think of Teoscar Hernandez, who just had 1 year, a moment like this, knowing that there was where I want to be, the opportunity, and man, he was a major part.
And you can't miss Tyler Glass now standing in there, and I'm glad to see him celebrating this moment. He's so tall. But that just kind of showed what this team had to overcome. You see him, he wasn't even available for this team in October. And there were a lot of doubters, a lot of people who didn't think the Dodgers could get to this point in October because of so many injuries to the starting pitching. But this team was not defined by those injuries. They overcame so much all season long, Jerry. They proved a lot of people wrong by winning 11 games in October.
You know, listen.
Amazing about this organization, because this organization isn't about this year. It's about... It's historic, and we had two historic organizations going at World Series, which made this World Series epic, and then the Dodgers prevailed. But yeah, it should be celebrated, because that's what the Dodgers are all about. It's not just about this one team, and you know, I'm eternally grateful to put on that uniform, because I'm a part of what the Dodgers are all about.
And Oral, I thought it was really telling when we were watching the final out, and the Dodgers became the National League champions when they won the pennants. And you and I are standing up there on that landing in the pavilion. And it was when you turned to me and you said, I didn't realize fully how much it meant to all these people. Yeah. Because you could see how much they were celebrating in that moment.
Yeah.
And then you had to almost look back and think all the joy you brought to so many people in 88. That's why Nomar's saying it is in part about you, because it is generational.
Yeah, we can think about Gibby's home.
Welcome to the good life. Welcome to the good life.
The wait is over.
Welcome to the good life.
And after all the talk.